Today we will be discussing this experiment to study the flow through a variable area duct and verify the Bernoulli equation. Apparatus used for this experiment will be Bernoulli equation verifying apparatus, stopwatch and measuring tape. Now this is the Bernoulli equation. We have seen this equation number of times in our theory classes. Now what does the Bernoulli equation say? It states that for ideal fluid, sum of pressure head plus kinetic head plus potential head is constant. This first term is your pressure head, second term is your kinetic head, and third term is your potential head. Now, I have told you in the theory class that this equation has a limitation, has assumption that it is applicable for an ideal case. We will try to verify this equation in a real case, and I have told you in the theory class that this is not applicable for the real case. Now we will try to see what we have studied in our theory class, is it okay or not. Students, in the setup we are having a variable area duct. Now this is a variable area duct. Area is maximum at the inlet and it reduces till the middle and then start increasing. Again, you can see here the area which is maximum here, it is reducing till the middle and then it increases at the outlet. Water enters from this side and leaves from this side. On this variable area duct, there are number of piezometric tubes. So piezometric tube, as you know, is used to measure the pressure head, and we will be calculating velocity at each point with the help of measuring of the flow rate. And flow rate, for measuring the flow rate, we are having an attachment in our Bernoulli equation verifying apparatus. And I will now take you to the setup, and I will show you this variable area duct and these piezometric tube. And there I will explain you how to take the value of these piezometric tubes, how to measure the value with the help of these piezometric tube. Students, this is our Bernoulli apparatus, and in this apparatus there are two reservoirs, reservoir number 1, reservoir number 2. Both these reservoirs are joined with the help of this duct, and this duct is your variable area duct. Why this is variable area duct? You can see here the area is maximum here and it reduces till the middle and then starts increasing again. So if the water flows from reservoir number 1 to 2, then at the entry the area is maximum and it reduces till the middle and then starts increasing till the reservoir number 2. Now to measure the various pressure at various points, we are having piezometric tube. These are the piezometric tubes used to measure the pressure head. So for measuring the flow rate, we are having this attachment. This is a tank whose area of cross section is 50 by 50. This setup is intentionally attached to the separators to measure the flow rate. So the method is very simple. We will maintain one level inside this tank, and then we will take the help of our stopwatch, and then we will start filling the water inside this tank. We will measure the time and the corresponding volume of the water that is coming in that particular time. If you divide that volume with that time, you will get the flow rate. Now the interesting thing is here that whatever the flow rate is coming here, same will be the flow rate throughout our apparatus. But this we have got from our continuity equation. A1 V1 is equal to A2 V2. The flow rate remains constant throughout the system. Students, I am switching on my apparatus now, and I will take one reading, and I will show you on the observation table how to do the calculation. So students, now I have switched on my apparatus, and now the flow has started, and you can see the flow has started taking place from reservoir number 1 to 2. You can see the flow has completely started. You can see this level, the water is clear, and the water has risen up in this piezometric tube. Water has risen in this piezometric tube.
you can see the level of the liquid. It is visible to you here. The level of the liquid is in this geometric cube is this, for this. And you can see the level here. And you can observe the pattern also. Okay, you can observe the pattern here also. The level is maximum for this cube. And this is in the middle. Now, it is very clear with this observation, the maximum at this and minimum here. Now, what is the reason for this? You can see here, the area is more. So, velocity will be less. So, kinetic head will be less. So, if your kinetic head is less, your pressure head will be more. Similarly, from this side, if the area is here, the velocity is maximum. Area is minimum, velocity is maximum. So, your velocity head will be more and therefore the pressure head will be less. Now, you can see the sum of pressure head and your kinetic head, they are remaining constant. And because the level of this cube, okay, the bottom level of this cube is at same level. You can see from the bottom line. If I take this floor as the bottom line, this floor as the bottom line, the level of this cube from the bottom is nearly same to all. Okay, nearly same to all the geometric cube. Since it is same to all the geometric cube, so the potential has to be same for all. Even you can assume one value, you can take even equal to zero. I am going to take you to the observation table, I will show you how to calculate and how to calculate the total head. We will be finding the total head corresponding to each physiometric cube. Then, for making the flow rate, we are having this attachment. Now, what is there in this attachment? What we are doing? We will be making one level inside this tank, which is called the niche level. Now, you can see there is the water inside the tank and the level is niche. It is 3.1. Now, initially the water is up to the height of 3.1. What I will do, I will reverse this wall and start accumulating the water inside the tank. And I will note down the time and I will note how much amount of liquid has come in 10 seconds. Now, you see what I am doing. I am reverting and I have opened my top wall. And after 10 seconds, I have again reverted the wall and this is the amount of the liquid that I have accumulated in 10 seconds. Now you can see here the level of the liquid is now 12.9. So this is the level we call final level. So final level is 12.9 and initial level is 3.1. So the level of the liquid that has rises up is 9.8. So how much amount of liquid that has come in this second, that is area of cross section multiplied by the height that has been seen. So area of cross section is 50/50 and the height that has seen is 9.8. So if you multiply this, you will get the flow rate. Now we will move to the observation table and we will do the calculation regarding this in our observation table.
So students, this is our observation table and you have asked you to note down the area of the tank. So this is the given to you. Area of the tank is 50 by 50 centimeters scale. So rise of the liquid in the main tank, we have also noted that it is 9.8 centimeter. Discharge, if you do all the calculation, the discharge will allow to be 2450 centimeter cube per second. So if you see the observation table in front of you, first column is corresponding to tube number. So there are total 11 tubes. So they are listed 1, 2, 3, 4, up to 11. Second column is corresponding to the distance from the inlet. Distance of each tube from the inlet. You can see it is on the increasing order. And this is the area of the cross section of the conduit and corresponding to each cube. So you can see it is first is 14.67, 13.2 and so on. These all values are given by
us to the manufacturer. So we have not calculated anywhere the value. This is given to you. So after that, you first calculate the velocity. Now you know that Q is equal to AV. We will use this formula to calculate the velocity. If Q is equal to AV, then V will be equal to Q divided by area. So Q, it is, we have calculated this Q. You will be using this Q here, and you will divide it corresponding area, and you will get the velocity at each point. Point number 1 to up to 11. You will calculate all the velocity. So after that, you will calculate your velocity head or kinetic head. So easier for you, you will take the value of V from here, divide V, multiply V divided by 2G. So V square upon 2G. Then you will get the pressure head. Pressure head you will note down from the level of the piezometric tube. So we have noted down and I have written all the values here. You can see the order. You can see it is decreasing and it decreases up to the middle and then start increasing. So you can well observe the pattern. So now V square upon 2G plus P upon rho G. If you add, you will get the total height. Z, you can assume it to be any constant value. You can take 5, you can take 6, any value you can take. Otherwise, to ease up your calculation, you can even take it to be 0. It will not affect you. It will not affect your results. So, you can see after adding up, you can get all these values. And you can observe the patterns here. What is there? The first value is 32.23, then 34.24, then 35.77, and so on. And you will observe here that these are not equal. Now, why these are not equal? Because whatever the Bernoulli's equation say, it is for the ideal case. But we are now performing this experiment on a real view. That's why these are not coming to be equal. Thus, we can say that our Bernoulli's equation stands for an ideal case, but it is not applicable for a real case.